Thanks, Rado, for telling us about the importance of proper dessert selection. So let's choose our desserts now. The earliest platform version that our app will support is gingerbread. At the current time, choosing gingerbread means we can cover over 99% of the devices active on Google Play Store. It's also the cutoff for using Google Play services for things like maps and location, and the Android support library. The support library package offers an implementation of UI features that were added in later releases of Android, but now can be used on older versions of the platform, so it's really useful. Notice that we picked the latest version of Gingerbread with API level 10 because it contains additional bug fixes that API level 9 doesn't have. Then we can go ahead and click Next. We're going to choose the template Blank Activity with Fragment. For background context, an activity serves as the presentation layer for our UI, and the fragment represents a behavior or portion of the screen. And now we have an option to modify the names of the files that will be auto-generated from the wizard. The name of our activity is main activity, and the layout will come from activity_main, which is an XML file. In a similar fashion, the fragments layout will come from fragment_main, which is also an XML file. I'm going to do a small change for the name of the menu file to be called main.xml, because on an older version of Android Studio, that was the default name. Then we go ahead and hit Finish. And now you should have a newly created Sunshine app with the files on the left here. By default, you may see the Android view of the files, which is a flattened version of the project structure, and it highlights the key Android source files that you'll need to edit. In this course, though, we're going to be using the project view because that's what we had on the older version of Android Studio. You can choose any view that you prefer, though. Make sure you wait for the Gradle build to finish. If you have any errors, you can check the guide in the instructor notes below. As a tip, you can check the build.gradle file, which is located under the app folder. You want to make sure that the compile SDK version and the target SDK version are both pointing at the latest stable version of the platform. In this case, it's 21 for the Android 5.0 Lollipop release. Once it's done building, we can add a custom app icon that's more fitting for our weather app. Right-click on the app folder and click New Image Asset. You can choose from any of the clip art options, or you can use the one that we provide in the download below. Then use the placeholder icon we provide in a download below. Now this will show up in the All Apps screen so that clicking on this app icon will launch our app. It will also show up in the Overview space if Sunshine is one of your most recent tasks. The other place you might see this app icon is in the action bar of our app. In certain videos of this course that were filmed earlier on KitKat, by default, the action bar shows the app icon. With material design on Lollipop and later, the app icon doesn't show up by default anymore. So don't worry if you don't see it. It's fine, and we're going to be styling the action bar later in Lesson 5 anyways.